All right, guys, today we are finally going to finish this PowerPoint for vital signs. And the last thing that we're going to talk about is visual acuity. Acuity meaning like accuracy, how good your vision is. So used to measure ability to see. Snellen chart is the name of the chart with the big E at the top. That checks your ability to see things that are far away, your distance vision. Ishihara is a fun word to say, and also a test that tests and sees colorblind. If you remember from Health Science 1, it's those little circles with the numbers in them, and it's full of dots, and they're different colors. And then a tonometer is intra, meaning within, ocular, the eyeball pressure. So a couple different ways that they can do this. Old school way of tonometry, first of all, it tests for glaucoma because it checks the pressure inside your eyeball. It used to be that little puff of air that they shot into your eye at the eye doctor. Now they numb up your eye and they put a little instrument right up against it and they shine a laser to the back and then the laser reads the pressure. No matter how they do it, it is terrifying if you're me. Maybe you're okay with it. I am not. So this is the Snellen chart. Again, 20/20 means you can see from 20 feet away and that number is always the same. The first number always stays 20. What the average person can see from, and then that's the second number. So if it's 20/20, you can see from 20 feet away what most people can see from 20 feet away. So that means you have normal vision. Say if you're 20/100, you have to be 20 feet away from something, whereas the average person could be 100 feet away and still see it. And again, that's your distance vision. This is the Ishihara. If you can't see these numbers, you need to FaceTime your doctor. The one on the left side of the screen is a 5, and the one on the right is a 29. Both of these would be red-green, I want to say. There's different forms of colorblind. So it's frequently, what is it, red-green, something blue, might be green-blue. I think my dad is green-blue. I didn't know my dad was colorblind until about 5 years ago. He was like, can you hand me that green shirt? And I was like, there's no green shirt here, Daddy. And he was like, that one right there, duh. I was like, oh, wow. Bless. All right. OD means oculus dexter, which means your right eye. So like they would say patient is 20/20 OD, 20/30 OS, meaning oculus sinister. I don't know why sinister is left. If you were left-handed, you should be very offended at that. I always think, so reading, like we read from left to right. So from left to right, I think it's SD, like standard definition. So sinister is the left eye and dexter is the right eye. And then OU means both. So usually people have a good eye and a bad eye. So you might be 20/20 in one, but 20/30 in the other. However, when you're looking with both, that strong eye really compensates. And so you're 20/20 overall. Reminder from Health Science 1, myopia means I can see myself. I am nearsighted. I have the ability to see things that are near to me. What I cannot see is the board, 20 feet away, versus hyperopia. Those are opposite. So hyper means far or excessive or increased. So they have the ability to see increased distances. They can see really far away. They can read the board when they're at the back of the room. But when they look down at their textbook, everything's a little bit blurry. I'm going to attach the skill for visual acuity. A few things to note. You always want to have them cover the eye, but never touch the eye. So that's usually why we don't use their hand. People have a tendency to push on their eyeball when they're covering it up with their hands. So we'll give them a little plastic occluder thing, or they can use an index card. But while you're doing it, you want to keep both eyes open. The patient should keep both eyes open because, again, they tend to squeeze on the eye that they shut, and then that can make their vision blurry for a while. Also, when you line them up at the little mark, that means that they're 20 feet away. Their heel needs to be on the mark, not their toe, because people with little feet would be, maybe 20 feet and a half away, whereas people with a size 15 would actually be like 22 feet away from the thing. So those are some things to cue in on there. All right, that's it. That's the end of this PowerPoint.